of two or three colors, main color with trim, or some balance of secondaries of which I had not previously conceived. I was overwhelmed in moments, or often just slightly elevated. I didn't know good feelings could be so simple. These are colors only designers know, or art school graduates, or people who are quite good with such aesthetics because they love it and have made a hobby of decorating. I have not, but I will make my best guesses. Teal, aqua blue, gray with a breath of violet, deep violet, midnight blue, soft green, powder blue, hot pink, orangish red, purplish red, deep red, indigo, shrill, pure yellow. I'm from a very gray place, Rusty, Michigan, and in addition to the factories and strip malls of our childhood landscape, there are the overcast skies that make up the majority of the year. These bursts of color pulled at my heart. The sun radiated into me. I wanted to keep it. One day I stood in front of a little yellow shotgun with lavender doors. Magenta flowers burst from bushes on either side. I just stood there in the narrow street, wishing someone I love had been there to share it. Maybe that was it, the perfect amount of longing that felt so good, that love with a twinge of sadness that something cannot be, no one else is there, or it cannot last forever. Too much longing is a terrible thing, but a touch of it is lovely. While I was standing there with my mouth slightly open, I assume, a short, thin, very tan white man of about 30 came out of his house and, seeing my expression, smiled. "Do you want to see the courtyard?" he asked, and I stood in that small space full of wandering Jews and bougainvillea. My head fell into my hands for a moment. "What would you call that purple?" I asked him. "I guess that's like a maroon," he said, "more brown than purple, brown with red."